sadness, most beautiful, most bright. This day the high and lowly through ages joined in tune. Sing holy, holy, holy to the great God triune. This day God's people meeting His holy scripture here, His living presence greeting through bread and wine made near. We journey on believing, renewed with heavenly might, from grace more grace receiving on this blessed day of light. That light our hope sustaining, we walk the pilgrim way. At length our rest attaining, our endless Sabbath day. We sing to Thee our praises, O Father, Spirit, Son. The Church her voice upraises to Thee, bless Three in One.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to all of you on this snowy Sunday morning, and welcome to all our family gathered with us on the internet. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to You all hearts are open, all desires known, and from You no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of Your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love You and worthily magnify Your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory be to God on high, and peace on earth from heaven, and God's good will unfailingly be to be all people given. We bless, we worship You, we raise for Your great glory thanks and praise.
Also with You.
Let us pray. O God, the strength of all who put their trust in You, mercifully accept our prayers, and because in our weakness we can do nothing good without You, give us the help of Your grace, that in keeping Your commandments we may please You, both in will and deed, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading is from Jeremiah. Thus says the Lord, cursed are those who trust in mere mortals and make mere flesh their strength, whose hearts turn away from the Lord. They shall be like a shrub in the desert and shall not see when relief comes. They shall live in the parched places of the wilderness, in an uninhabited salt land. Blessed are those who trust in the Lord, whose trust is the Lord. They shall be like a tree planted by water, sending out its roots by the stream. It shall not fear when heat comes, and its leaves shall stay green. In the year of drought, it is not anxious, and it does not cease to bear fruit. The heart is devious above all else. It is perverse. Who can understand it? I, the Lord, test the mind and search the heart, to give to all according to their ways, according to the fruit of their doings. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 1. We'll read by the whole verse. Happy are they who have not walked in the counsel of the wicked, nor lingered in the way of sinners, nor sat in the seats of the scornful.
Their delight is in the law of the Lord, and they meditate on his law day and night.
They are like trees planted by streams of water, bearing fruit in due season, with leaves that do not wither. Everything they do shall prosper.
It is not so with the wicked. They are like chaff, which the wind blows away.
Therefore, the wicked shall not stand upright when judgment comes, nor the sinner in the counsel of the righteous.
For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked is doomed.
A reading from 1 Corinthians. Now, if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, then Christ has not been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then our proclamation has been in vain, and your faith has been in vain. We are even found to be misrepresenting God, because we testified of God that he raised Christ, whom he did not raise, if it is true that the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those also who have died in Christ have perished. If for this life only we have hoped in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, who left the heavens, our Lord. life and peace to bring. To dwell in lowliness with us, our pattern and our King. He to the lowly soul will still himself impart, and for his dwelling and his throne will choose the pure in heart. Lord, we thy presence seek, may this our blessing be. Give us a pure and lowly heart, a temple fit for thee.
Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus came down with the 12 apostles and stood on a level place with a great crowd of his disciples and a great multitude of people from all Judea, Jerusalem, and the coast of Tyre and Sidon. They had come to hear him and to be healed of their diseases. And those who were troubled with unclean spirits were cured. And all in the crowd were trying to touch him, for power came out of him and healed all of them. Then he looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. All week long, I've been pondering today's scriptures, and I've been wondering just how I can convey to you their content without haranguing you for an hour. Since common wisdom is that a picture is worth a thousand words, I thought I'd provide you with the briefest possible summary as I see it. There you go. This is what today's scriptures say, at least to me. Of course, that's silly, but that is what I'm seeing in these texts, that what God is looking for in us is upside down from what the rest of the world thinks. Now, we've all heard the Beatitude so many times and listened to so many sermons on the Beatitude that it's hard to hear them as anything other than overly familiar platitudes. And sometimes they're even used to shut people up. For example, "Blessed are you poor." Well, in other words, quit belly aching and don't think that I'm going to share the contents of my wallet with you. But just think how incredibly shocking the Beatitudes must have been the first time that they were preached. Blogger Judy Allen wrote an intriguing contemporary version of the Beatitudes, and she calls them the anti-Beatitudes. I thought a slightly different translation of the Beatitudes might convey a bit of the startlement value they must have had for Jesus' hearer. So here's my version of her version. Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Woe to you who are rich in self-sufficiency and pride, for yours are the transient kingdoms of this world. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Woe to you who hunger and thirst for pleasure, for you will become jaded. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Woe to you who are blind to your spiritual impoverishment, for ignorance is not bliss. Blessed are you when people hate you and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what your ancestors did to the prophets. Woe to you who are oblivious to God's standard of righteousness, for you are free to say whatever you need to get ahead. The Beatitudes take our preconceived notions and turn them on their head. Just look at what was going on right before Jesus began to teach his disciples about the difference between his way and worldly ways. Jesus was, after all, a rock star. He had been all over his region and had gained a vast following. We're told that his groupies from all Judea, Jerusalem, and the coast of Tyre and Sidon were coming to hear him. And his reputation was not limited only to his native area, because it extended even to the northern pagan cities like Tyre and Sidon. Not only was he a great charismatic preacher, he also had the gifts of healing. He could even heal those with unclean spirits, which in those days is what they called mental illness. Unlike some of the other fake messiahs and magicians of the age, Jesus was not concerned with making a well-paying career out of his mission. We never hear anything about him charging people for treatments or selling high-cost tickets for admissions to his events. Even more than that, if you look closely at the text, you'll see that he taught all of the disciples, not just his closest 12 buddies, and he healed all the multitude. Imagine how much money he could have been making. And goodness, how much more sensible and strategic it would have been to keep his wisdom limited to the secret few and heal only a few at a time, so there would be a never-ending line of folks wanting to see him. But that wasn't Jesus' agenda. He was much more concerned with turning upside down people's attitudes about God's expectations versus society's expectations. And we see similar sorts of reversals in the other readings. From Jeremiah, woe to you who trust merely in mortals and the physical, You shall be surrounded by a dry and desolate world and won't be able to see it, even when help has come for you. Blessed are you who trust in God. You will be like a strong, stable, healthy tree with such a good supply of nourishing water that you won't be threatened when trouble comes. From the Psalm. Woe to you who are wicked and scornful. You will be judged and blown away in the wind of the spirit like dry husks. Blessed are you who delight in God's way. You will be like the psalmist's healthy tree. From 1 Corinthians. Blessed are you who believe that Christ has been raised from the dead, even if the world doesn't. For you too, who are believers, will be resurrected through his resurrection. Woe to you who do not believe in the resurrection. You and all those who have already died simply perish. What a devastating statement. Just try to imagine that you're hearing these scriptures for the first time. Although many people in Jesus' day would have known Jeremiah and the Psalms, Jesus' words would have been new and startling. And hopefully they will make us a little uncomfortable as well, just like they must have made Jesus' hearers. They're asking us to fight our complacency and move into a space beyond ourselves. And perhaps we can imagine how these texts can help us become new in our own minds and hearts, a little less caught up in our own self-centeredness and a little bit closer to God. Surely it will be wonderful to hear, blessed are you, and to know that the resurrection is ours to look forward to. Amen.
Let us affirm the faith of the church in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the People. Trusting in the Lord who shows us the way of righteousness and blessing, let us offer our prayers with faith and confidence, saying, God of life, hear our prayer. For the Church, remembering especially Michael, our presiding bishop, and Kevin, our bishop, that the power and truth of Christ's resurrection may give us vision for our lives and the courage to live for God each day. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For this parish family, that we may see beyond the false answers of the world and deepen our trust in God who provides all that we need for life and wholeness. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For all who are persecuted or suffer for their commitment to Christ, that they may be witnesses to the new life given by God. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may be inspired to new efforts to seek peace and eliminate strife, famine, disease, and oppression from all corners of the earth. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For all those whose lives are burdened by the power of nature, for those who live in the cold, and for those dealing with storms and flooding, that God will keep them safe and bring them to a new day. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For all those who live and work in places of danger and violence, especially members of our armed forces, for the hungry and the homeless, the sick, and those in need of our prayers, remembering especially Jackson, Father Don, Toby, Lisa, Millie, Megan, Jane, Wani, Carly, Cindy, Dominic, Ted, Taylor, Marlene, Lori, Andrew, Chris, Michelle, Fran, Ryan, Pam, Terry, Robert, Kate, Joshua, Jody, Mother Gwendolyn Jane, Amelia, Karen, Stacy, Julius, Sarah, Chris, Louis, Jose, Dan, Lily, Mark, Cal, Sheila, Rebecca, Michaela, Denise, Bill, Art, John, David, Jen, Linda, Katie, Ashley, Andy, Audrey, Grace, Joseph, Ray, David, Cindy, Steve, Diane, Martin, Bob, Mary, Joseph, Pastor Gary Walbert, and for those in the military and all first responders, especially those in harm's way and their families, Sean, Will, Jamie, Andrew, Zachary, Kevin, and Kyle, that they may find the help and strength they need. God of life,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died, remembering especially Jackie Tompkins, Mother Jane Gaeta, Joseph Hall, and those we now name either silently or aloud. That in God's kingdom they may know the fulfillment of the resurrection promise. God of life,
hear our prayer.
Lifting our voices with all creation, with Mary the God-bearer, Margaret, Benedict, and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Christ.
To you, O Lord our God.
God of every blessing, Hear the prayers we offer this day, and plant your people like trees by water in the garden of your kingdom, that they may bear the fruit of righteousness through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor.
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
And now may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Peace and joy to everyone. And thank you for joining us and praying for your favorite team, whatever that might be, in the upcoming Super Bowl. I checked in before the service, and George assured me that they were playing in Los Angeles, so we didn't have to worry about people trying to drive through the snow and slush to Philly. So enjoy a good and fun afternoon. Just a reminder, if you haven't gotten them already, you will have in your mail a note from me with information about our Lenten reading programs. So please do let me know if you plan to join one or both groups, just because I need to kind of coordinate, make sure we don't have 45 people in one and two in another. So I'd be grateful for that. And also, if you have any issues about ordering books online, let me know. I'll be glad to get them for you. And we'll just arrange a time for you to pick them up. Walk in love, as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Things come of thee, O Lord.
And of thine own have we given thee.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here. Him above the heavenly host, praise Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right, and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. And gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension. We offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us to this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
Gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Since at this time we are not able to receive our Blessed Savior in person, I invite you to pray this prayer of spiritual reception as we receive him in our hearts.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the holy, most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray.
Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Christ, the Son of God, be manifest in you, that your lives may be a light to the world. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.